everybody. Thanks for joining me today, Dr. Ross Marcogiani, with another great conversation at Turnpaugh Health and Wellness Center. Today, we're going to be talking about macronutrient ratio for your body type. We'll be talking about the three most common body types. We'll be talking about appropriate nutrition for each body type. And then we'll be talking about the proper macronutrient ratio for that specific body type. Let's dive in. So first, before we dive in, I want to talk about two things. So some people might not be aware of what is a macronutrient. So macronutrient is, there's three primary components: carb, protein, and fat. So these are our three main macronutrients, which we'll talk about in a moment, that make up the foods that we eat. Also, let's talk about body types. So there are typically three most common body types here. Typically, you have your ectomorph, your mesomorph, and your endomorph. We'll describe more details in each frame about each body frame, but I just want you to be aware that there are three frames here, or three types. Just to be aware, a little bit of a disclaimer. So this is mainly the macronutrient ratios created are going to be for maintaining a healthy fat to muscle ratio. This isn't for weight loss or for building muscle. If that's something that you're interested in specific to your body frame, please reach out to one of the practitioners at the office and we'll make sure we establish a very specific regimen to your goals in mind. So just be aware of that. So the first frame that we have is an ectomorph. This is typically our slender, more long body frame. This body frame tends to lose weight very easily. It's that individual that if they gain weight, they can lose weight by just looking at them. Also, this frame has difficulty to gain muscle mass or hold on to muscle mass. They typically have a lower bone density, so there's more bone demineralization going on in later in life. So for someone later in life, making sure you're taking the appropriate measures to evaluate if you have decreased bone density. So getting a DEXA scan would be important. These individuals have a very fast metabolism and they do well with consuming carbs. These are mainly these frames, these long, slender, narrow shoulders, flat chest, long legs, long limbs. A lot of the time they're your runners, so that's to be aware of. Next, we have our mesomorph. This is the individual that can hold on to muscle mass very easily. They also have a fast metabolism and can balance their weight pretty easily. These are the individuals that don't really have to work extremely hard in building muscle. That's one of the attributes here. They can utilize carbs, fats, but do best with using proteins. They have a lot of what we call metabolic flexibility. Like we mentioned, they also have fast metabolism. And we notice with this frame that they have wider shoulders, a larger chest, and a narrow waist. So kind of think about like that upside down triangle frame is what we're looking here for the individual that falls into a mesomorph. Next, we have our endomorph. So really important, I wanted to make sure we talked about this. This isn't specifically someone who is considered fat or overweight. The reason why I wanted to show this video is, as you can see on the viewing right, is that you have an individual that is a little bit overweight, that looks a little bit heavy. But you have the same individual in the picture beside that who's able to slim down and actually become a little bit more toned. So this isn't necessarily a body type that is fat and overweight. This body type does hold on to fat or adipose tissue easier than the other two types. They have a larger frame, so this is more of your block frame from shoulders to waist. The shoulders are basically almost in line with the waist for the width. They have larger bone density, so they have a little bit more mass because their bones are a little bit larger, a little bit slower metabolism. But the best quality to this body type is that this is typically the strongest body type. So they end up having the most strength. And they will do best, surprisingly, with a more higher fat diet because they don't utilize carbohydrates as effectively or efficiently. We'll dive into that in just a moment. So, talking about macronutrient ratio and specific strategies for an ectomorph on how to maintain a healthier body weight with some muscle. So this individual does best with aerobic exercise. This is typically, like we've mentioned to earlier, long distance running, anything that involves a constant pace or constant activity during an exercise. They do better with a higher carbohydrate ratio, like we talked about. The carbohydrate ratio that I would like this individual to consume would be about 40% carbohydrate, 35% protein, and 25% fat. So a lot of people may not understand what this may look like. So I basically broke it down to an individual who's around 150 pounds. I have a master's in nutrition, so this is something that is very easy for me to do and very quickly. So this would be the thought process that you would want to place if your weight wasn't exactly 150. You would basically take your weight, times it by 10. That would be your total caloric intake for that day. And then what you would do is you would find out the ratio, you know, the 40%, 35%, 25%, plug that ratio into your overall caloric intake for the day. And then whatever that number is for your carbohydrate, for your protein, you're gonna divide that number by 4. And then whatever your ratio is, that number is for your ratio of fats, you're gonna divide that by 9. That can get confusing. If it's something that you don't wanna dive into, please find someone who can do that for you and set you up for success. So let's go back here. We set this macronutrient ratio for an individual who would be 150 pounds. So again, with the carbohydrate ratio of 40% of carbs per day, 35% of protein per day, and 25% of fat per day is what your overall intake would be for that day. So this would break down to 150 grams per day of carbohydrate, about 131 grams a day of protein, and about 41 grams per day, excuse me for the spelling error there, but it would be 41 grams of fat per day. So that would be a macronutrient ratio for an individual around 150 pounds who has an ectomorph frame that wants to maintain some muscle mass, but as well have an adequate fat to muscle ratio. Next, we have our mesomorph. This is someone who does best with anaerobic and aerobic exercise. So we talked about what aerobic is. Anaerobic is more strength training or more weight-based training. So these individuals would find themselves in the gym pretty frequently. They do best with a paleo template. And just to let you know, the ectomorph, I still would want you resembling a paleo template. But I would want, obviously, the macronutrients shifted to more carbohydrates. But that doesn't mean you can, you're going and consuming wheat and various grains, pasta, white breads in the grains, healthier grains, consuming sweet potatoes, yuca, plantains. Your vegetables will count as carbohydrates. So color of the rainbow veggies. Making sure if we're consuming carbs, we're consuming the healthy, little bit more starchy carbohydrate that doesn't cause your blood sugar to spike rapidly. So slow release carbohydrates are the most effective, and obviously gluten free. So let's get back to our mesomorph here. So we would consume a paleo template excluding exercise, meaning for these individuals post exercise, it's really important that they consume a carbohydrate either solution or carbohydrate meal. I would typically recommend, it depends on your weight, but anywhere between 15 to 50 grams of carbohydrate post-exercise would be the most beneficial. Again, I know that's wide, it depends on your weight. But other than that, it would be a moderate carbohydrate or moderate to low carbohydrate consumption. So our ratios that we would consume per day would be carbohydrate, 15% of your daily intake would be from carbs, 35% of your daily intake would be from protein, 35%, and then about 50% from fat. So your daily intake would consist of 50% from fat. This was for an individual who weighs around 200 pounds. And so that would look like carbs per day. You would consume about 75 grams per day of carbohydrates. For protein, you would consume about 175 grams per day of protein and about 111 grams per day of fat. So that's 75 grams for carb, 175 grams for protein, and 111 for fat. Lastly here, we have our endomorph. So the endomorph does better with purely anaerobic exercise. These are those strength competitors. These are the very strong individuals. They would do better with a little bit more of a ketogenic diet. That's because they don't utilize carbohydrates as effectively, don't burn them as effectively. So we want to transition to someone burning, these individuals burning ketones. These will cause, this will cause them to not hold on to fat or adipose tissue as much. The reason why I have an asterisk here is because if we decide to go to a ketogenic diet, it's very, very strict. This is probably the most strict of all three of the diets. There's not a lot of room for flexibility, and I'd recommend not consuming excessive amounts of dairy for your fat consumption, because there are gonna be a lot of strategies that you need to implement for fat consumption, but I would not want my patient to go heavy, heavy, heavy into the dairy. So what this ketogenic ratio would look like, you'd be doing about 5% of your daily intake would be from carbohydrates, about 20% of your daily intake would be from protein, and about 75% of your daily intake would be from fat. So this was done for an individual with around 250 pounds. Their carbs per day would be 31 grams. Their protein per day would be about 125 grams, and their fat per day would be about 208 grams. So as you can see, significantly more fat than the previous two diets or lifestyle approaches. Really important, some really good fats on how to do this would be lots of good seafood, more smash fish, trying to reduce your tuna, your swordfish. Those would be seafoods that hold on to mercury a little bit more. So lots of seafood, but trying to avoid your larger game seafood that hold on to mercury. Lots of avocado, good healthy oils. Avocado oil, a little bit of coconut oil, good saturated fat, using various coconut oils, or excuse me, using various avocado oil, duck fat, a little bit of bacon fat, some grass-fed butter is okay. These are all going to be really important sources of fat that you're going to need to maintain this ratio. So again, just don't go hog wild in the dairy. If you do decide to go with dairy, try to go raw organic dairy, possibly A2 milk, lots of coconut yogurt. Those would be the approaches that I would take. Thank you for your time, for listening today. And I know the holiday seasons are around, so if you want to get ahead of the game instead of, you know, waiting till January to hit the mad rush for you know, weight, for your weight, please reach out to the practice. And if there's anyone that you know that would benefit from this, please share this video. Like I always tell you, the most important thing is I want to provide information so you can make informed decisions on your health. Thank you for your time and have a great day.